We have two Canadian performers here today. We have Carol Kalan and Kevin Russo, who's born in Montreal. Here we go. He's going to push down, push over, get a little bit of airspeed. And there he goes. Up onto the vertical. He's going to roll the airplane, bring it around. He calls this the quarter clover. He's going to go back to straight level here. Here in a second. Ah, love that sound. You're going to hear a lot of that today. That's the tips of the propeller as they go supersonic. That's that rapping sound you hear as he completes a loop. That deep throaty rumble, there we go. There's that aileron roll. You push that stick over, it doesn't even feel like it's connected. The forces are that light. It's going to bring the airplane back around here. That deep throaty rumble, that's the sound of the actual engine. That's the noise you hear. I'm sorry, that's the music you hear coming out of the exhaust. Diving down, getting up a little bit of airspeed here. Sound, gotta love it. By the way, you don't hear that inside the airplane. Coming up over the top, he's weightless right now. He's got plenty of speed going here. By the way, this is a pretty big airplane. It weighs about 5,500 pounds. Carries two people, an instructor and a student pilot. Or just somebody along for the ride. Here's loop number two. There's that propeller. And here's the crazy thing. When you hear that sound of the propeller, you're actually losing efficiency. Makes about a 5 mile an hour difference if you don't have that prop wrapping there. But you know what? At an air show, we're all about the sound. So they push that prop all the way up, let her go supersonic, just so you know that they're out there having fun with the airplane. Coming back in, keep your eyes on Kevin Russo. Pulls the airplane up just a little bit. Here's one. There's two. Here's three. And there's four. Four. Hesitation roll. He stops precisely every 90 degrees. Did you notice the airplane just seems to snap into place? He's going to reposition the airplane around here, coming back from the right. Now, Kevin joined the Air Force when he was 22 years old. He's made quite a career out of it, too. He's got over 20,000 hours of flight time. He soloed on his 16th birthday, got his pilot's license on his 17th birthday. He's diving down, getting a little bit of speed. He holds commercial, glider, helicopter, and ATP, airline transport pilot ratings, as he pulls her up over the top. Watch for the half Cuban. Here comes the roll out of it. And now he's going to come up over the top again. He's going to ease back gently on his head. The G-forces are going to pull him, push him into the seat. He's weightless right there. There's a little thing there called panic factor up at the top. That's when your seat is no longer touching the seat. Plenty of horsepower, 600 of them up front, and he rolls the airplane out into a half Cuban 8 turnaround. You will see a lot of them jump. It's a very popular turnaround maneuver meant to keep you in front of the crowd. Here's an aileron roll, stick hard over to the left. This graceful lady, you're doing it at about 180 miles per hour. You pull up a little bit, push that stick hard over, she comes right around on you. When your wings are level with the horizon, you push the stick back into the middle and you're good to go. Coming around from the left, keep your eyes on Kevin Russo. Here we go. Here's the pitch up. Here's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. The 8-point hesitation. Roll stopping precisely every 45 degrees. I know, I measured them at an air show 1 year ago. I'm going to bring this beautiful lady around here, and he's going to demonstrate to you the art of the barrel roll. It's like an aileron roll, a little rudder in her. Here we go with the barrel roll. Oh, that looks like a lot of fun, let me tell you. Well, let's see now. We've seen the four-point roll. We've seen the eight-point roll. We've seen the barrel roll. Are there any other rolls out there? Well, yes, there is. And Kevin is going to come right around here, and he's going to demonstrate it for you right now. Watch for the nose coming up. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. The 16 point hesitation roll. Kevin got it right. I just can't count. He's having so much fun in that airplane right now. I gotta tell you, if you've never done any aerobatics at all, you really should get out and try it. It is the ultimate roller coaster ride. And you roller coaster freaks, you know how much fun that is. Propeller again, he's gonna pull up. Coming up over the top, he's gonna lose a little bit of airspeed going over the top. But he will more than make it up on the way down. He's having way too much fun with this airplane. This, by the way, is the lowest time T6. Actually, I should say T6. This is the Navy version, the SNJ, specifically the SNJ-5, as it rolls out of the implement there. Get your cameras and camcorders ready, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin Russo is going to bring this beautiful SNJ-5 in for a photo pass. All right, you're wondering, what's the difference between the AT6 and the SNJ-5? It's pretty simple, actually. It's just the angle of incidence on the engine. What they do is on the SNJ, they tilt the motor to the right a little bit more to counteract the torque. Get your cameras and camcorders ready. He's coming in from the right behind us here. He's going to set up for his photo pass. You're going to get some beautiful pictures of this airplane. Kevin Russo, the SNJ-5. Gotta love that airplane. Kevin, you have a safe trip home. We'll see you tomorrow, buddy. Okay, so now you've seen World War II vintage aerobatics.